Hey guys, what's up? It's Melody, and today we're going to be talking about a couple of ways that you can boost your mood in the holiday season and in the colder winter months. So these are just some of the things that I do to get myself back into a reset or refresh mode. The very first thing is I really pay attention to everything that I'm feeling in the moment. Journal, but for me personally, I really like to write poetry. And it doesn't matter in what medium that you do it in, but if you can just get your thoughts out on paper, it kind of gives a lot of clarity and peace and more compassion. So that's one of the things I really like doing in the winter months. So usually there's fall festivals, or my family is throwing a, you know, Thanksgiving, and you know, there's Halloween and there's Christmas. I try to get out as much as possible. In the winter months, I usually stick to two beverages, and that's a hot tea. And I usually have this specific tea that helps your immune system. And I really, so basically there's an elderberry syrup in Whole Foods that helps your immune system. So I just drink the tea of that specific plant. So hot cocoa is really nice. You can put a big fat marshmallow in there, or you can put a cinnamon stick. You can go all out with the hot cocoa, put some coconut whipped cream on it, or you can just keep it very simple and classic. So I just got this new Senna machine, which is basically super lightweight to touch because I'm a court reporter. And so practicing every day on this Senna machine, it really helps me to keep my skill up and to sharpen my, in stenography we have briefs and stuff like that, to make our writing so much more efficient. It really makes me very happy and my mood buoyant if my skill set is way up to par. The second to the last thing that I really like doing is I like to go ahead and exercise photography, because photography is an exercise in observation, which is really delightful. It's really nice to get out of the house, even just at the Science Center. It doesn't have to be hiking or anything like that, or festivals, and just filming or taking some pictures and stuff like that. That is really enjoyable. The very last thing that I like to do to keep my mood up in the winter months, I get excited every time there's a winter, because the seasons offer all new opportunities. So in the springtime, summertime, you can renovate your whole house and do all kinds of activities outside of the house. It's just incredible for that time period. But the end of the season is perfect for doing all of your hobbies indoors. So I've been making these blankets, which I have a whole video on, and I absolutely love making blankets from scratch and doing any kind of sewing, candle making, soap making, anything that speaks to you, even jewelry making, like the solar system or something like that. There's so many ideas out there. For sure there's a niche for you. So what I found over the years, because I've done so many hobbies at this point, and what I found over the years is I really like the hobbies that are not dangerous. First of all, I like the hobbies that are not dangerous. You know, having a lion in your house, that's a little dangerous. And woodworking is not the safest hobby, but I really enjoy photography, writing poetry. Writing poetry is the safest. One hobby that I absolutely am in love with currently is making blankets. I don't see that stopping anytime soon, so I'm going to move right on to socks after blankets. Last year I made a bunch of handmade candles and I had a blast with that. Just pull up that video and just get to knitting. Don't hesitate. You know, if you're going to do photography of stars, you know, if you're going to do photography, just get your camera out. If you just keep track on what really matters, then everything that you have will always be enough. And the next thing that I like to do is I like to get my blood flowing. So I like to work out during the winter months, especially during the winter months. And then that way, when the new year hits and all the New Year's resolution starts and everything like that, I'll already be in full swing of it. So as the weather's starting to turn, that's when I start going ahead and hitting the treadmill and going to classes. There's so many classes around town if you can afford to do it. You know, there's aerial yoga, there's regular yoga, there's Tai Chi, there's karate, and you can just pick one that you feel like you'll just love, or if you're like me, you can try a couple of them. And it's really nice to join into the community in some way. There are many free activities like people watching and going to the library, but taking a class and getting your blood moving is perfect. Nice to just zone out, to stop your brain from thinking. I think honestly the hardest part of relaxing, especially in this day and age with technology and everything like that, I think the hardest part is overthinking. So the hardest part is recognizing that you're overthinking. So when, as you get into the anxious state or an overthinking state, if you can recognize it and kind of see yourself and you can catch it as it's going and redirect it. And just that redirection, whether it's into activity like moving on the treadmill, writing poetry, if you can redirect some of that energy, you'll be so much more at peace. And hanging out with family and friends and being very cognizant of the energy and the influence that everyone around you has, and putting yourself in the best. For me, when I'm talking to my mom and my sister, I'm in my best mode. And that's because I'm very cognizant and very sensitive to the energies of people around me. And for a long time in my life, younger years, I had no awareness whatsoever of any energy that I was giving off or any energy of anybody around me. But if you can be cognizant of overthinking and be cognizant of the energies around you, your whole life will shift. But also to do the things that really matter to you. Like I said, writing poetry for me. For some people, it's photography as well. I like photography because it causes me to stretch outside of my comfort zone and to really observe things at a very still level. So photography is really nice. You can combine it with going outside of the house. So all these things really help to keep my mood up, just observation and getting in touch with how I feel about things. The next thing is to go and have a really nice bubble bath. Having a really big fluffy bubble bath is a real delight. If you guys like this video, if you did, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't added me on Instagram, if you guys leave comments on Instagram, I try to get back to them as much as I can. So add me on Instagram and I will see you guys next week. Thank you so much for watching.